All right, so we've lost the roll, and our opponent has decided to keep his hand. This hand is a little landlight, so we're going to mulligan. And this hand's a bit better. It's going to be turn three compulsive research. And so then we're off. Hopefully we don't get overrun too much. This is not a bad hand, and unfortunately Jace... Oh no, wait. Knight's complementary does reduce the cost of Jace. Turn three Jace. Can't go wrong with that, right? Well, there's our land, so we've got plenty of land, so in case this guy dies, we can always just go compulsive research into Jace, and that should be pretty good. Yeah. Looks like we've got the mirror. So, good, and cast this bad boy. Have plenty of lands to discard to this, so don't really care, just looking to upgrade. Figures. Not really too much of a fan of this figure. It's good against aggro, but I'm pretty disappointed that he got such good value out of that. Hopefully he doesn't have misdirection for this. That would be moderately unfortunate. So we're just going to go ahead and... Oh, let's slow our roll. Let's play our land first, then compulsive research. And discard an island. And we can play Jace next turn, or Talran, depending on what he does. We have the strip mine. I think he may be out of lands if Tech Edge is his last land, so what I kind of want to do is just play the strip mine and hope, but that's pretty bad value out of our turn, just because we have two fours that we want to play. And so if we end up... it would be better just to play a 4 and then a 4 plus strip mine. And so we don't really need this swamp just yet, so we'll go ahead and play this island and get Jace onto the battlefield. See what he thinks about that. Well, Jace resolves, so I guess we can go ahead and factor fiction. No, that's not bad. I've got a flashback spell. And then a real spell, so he's probably gonna. these go on the bottom, so probably just gonna take the cloud skates. Might just take the pile of two. We have plenty of land, so it's not like we're in too much of a hurry to take this land. I'm actually kind of interested to see how he's gonna split. He's probably just gonna put the cloud skate alone. Yep, and that's what he does. And I think I'm going to go for the Cloudscape. If he plays something scary, then I want to be able to have the option of taking it. So we'll put these on the bottom. I mean, Forbidden Alchemy is better with Talran, but I would prefer to have him not resolve something very, very scary. And so next turn, depending on what he does, main one, we're going to strip his island, and then we're going to play Talran, and then he can do stuff. Baleful Strix. Don't want to gate that, so I think we'll just let Jace take care of him. And looks like he's going to be playing Mono Black pretty soon. So let's go ahead and get the formalities out of the way. Get out of here, you dirty island. That was a pretty good turn. Everything went according to plan, and all he did was get a Baleful Strix into play, which was basically cycling. Granted, we're not going to be able to attack, and we have to keep on plus one-ing, but that's fine. And he's got another swamp, so I wonder if he has a handful of blue cards. We should take advantage of this. Could probably Demonic Tutor for Vidalkin Shackles. Yeah, I guess we can just play Old Man of the Sea. And we can plus one and Demonic Tutor. I don't know if we're right. I'll have to. Probably something that's really good. Like, and we can start chaining off. We can go for a deep analysis. That'd be gas. Let's see. What do we have in our graveyard? We have compulsive research and Knight. See it familiar? So I think I'm just going to go for deep analysis. That's going to give us a ton of value. And that'll let us keep on getting more tokens. And if he ends up drawing out of it, deep analysis should work out pretty well. Alternatively, we can go for shackles, but I would rather not show him shackles and just show him something dorky. So we'll go for that. Now we'll play the old man, start beating his face in. But I have the sneaking suspicion that he's probably going to concede if he doesn't draw a land. So we'll just have to wait and see. Definitely not attack him with Talran into his death touch guy. That would just not make too much sense. I can only hope that he boards out Disfigure. Ah, there's his island. Maybe we should have gone for opposition. Is this a Black Sun Zenith? Ah, that's unfortunate. We do have Volrath Stronghold to get stuff back if we want to. I guess we can just play, and we can factor fiction and see what happens. Probably get a small black creature, just because we've got a few more. So let's see what happens first, then we can decide what to do. I don't want to play the stronghold until I can get a creature back. You know, looks like we're getting something good. Now that the secret is out. Now, since we have opposition, I don't want to take this Vidalcan Shackles, I think, just because generally this type of deck isn't going to have very many creatures, and we only have three islands, so the creatures that they end up running are generally on the larger side, so I think I'm going to take this Negate, because opposition takes care of any creatures, so at this point I'm only afraid of sorcery stuff out of him. So what we can do is just play opposition. We can play opposition and then pass the turn, or we can play Pristine Talisman in opposition. And we do have the Cloudscape, so I think it'll be better to do that. Just because if he plays a permanent that we don't like, we can always just bounce it with the Cloudscape. And I don't really want to suspend the Cloudscape, so we'll go ahead and put that guy back. And once we get a creature, we'll be able to start tapping down his lands, which will be pretty good. So there's his second source of blue, so we'll go ahead and set a stop for his upkeep next turn if we end up playing a creature. Ideal, I'd play Volrath Stronghold to get Talran back. Tameo. Okay, well that's fine. We can bounce Tameo, then tap his island during his upkeep. If we draw a regular land, then we don't have to play this Aura Stronghold. Yeah, I guess that's good enough. So go ahead and plus one. Now we can play both. Bounces Tameo, so to stop during his upkeep. I want to hold on to this Far West Stronghold, so I'm just going to leave it like that. I already plus the Jace, so go ahead and tap down both of his blue sources so he can't recast the Tameo. And if he doesn't have a Wrath, we should be pretty good. I guess that position's working out pretty well. I mean, we played against the control deck, so generally not going to have too many creatures to tap down and just lands, which is generally what matchup is about. Ooh, some counters. Okay, so I think we can probably afford to just Volrath Stronghold back our Talran, play that, and that'll start giving us enough guys that we can just level up our guy to a 2, 1, to or to a 1, and then that'll give us enough to use negate. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'll go ahead and see if we can just factor fiction first. Why not? Let's get the formalities out of the way. Yeah, there's some garbage. It's probably going to give us Fathom Seer versus Impulse Island. Fathom Seer and Island. Well, I guess I'm going to go ahead and take the Fathom Seer, since we already have both of our counter spells. And we can go ahead and bash with 1. And I think I don't have to play with the Stronghold just yet. Just attack for 2. And now we can, let's see, play this and morph the Fathom Seer. And I still want to be able to cast Negate or Dissipate. It's probably Negate, so we can level this guy up. So let's go ahead and put him face down. And then we can level up. And then tap down his blue sources and his upkeep again, blah blah blah. Still have all this deep analysis action. And he's brainstorming, sure. Not too much of a fan of brainstorm without shuffle effects, but you know, it's still a card to run if you need playables. It'll at least filter, or if you're in a bit of a situation, draw you into something that you could need if you don't have that already. It's also good with Talrand. And there's an island. And now I can cast another blue spell. Liliana of the Veil. Don't know how much I care about that. I think that's actually fine. So we'll just go ahead and let that resolve. Just going to make a sack creature. We'll unmorph Fathom Seer in response. Draw some cards. 7, 8, 9, 8. And sack our Fathom Seer. So now we've got some stuff to do. Ooh, Gilded Lotus. Well, that was certainly a card. What is that going to let us do? That'd be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can cast Crawl Home Commander. So let's, yeah, I think let's see if this resolves first. Actually, let's go ahead and attack Liliana. Now we can play this thing and still have Negate up if we want to. So we have the Strip Mine, so you could have Rashad in port to sort of screw us from having Negate, or you could have Into the Royal. I think it's more likely that he'll have Into the Royal, and this will let us level up 1. And if he plays a creature, I don't really care too much, so we'll go ahead and do that. And keep on tapping down his blue. And he's floating mana response, but we'll auto yield. I guess we'll set a stop during his draw. So if he wants to cast something, he'll have to tap more mana, and then we can just tap down his island and his draw, and he won't be able to float it to his main phase. He already brainstormed, so he knows exactly what he's drawing, so that's probably going to be something that's bad. And he'll probably do the same thing, but he's not going to do anything. Oh, and here he goes. What does he have? Is it Into the Royal? Venser. And I guess Venser resolves. What's he going to bounce? He's probably going to bounce a creature. Yeah, sure. Ghouls are as assassin. Doesn't do anything. You're fighting a losing war on that front. Snapcaster Mage. Well, that does some stuff. So I think what we're going to do is go to the next game because he's tired of fighting. Alright, so going to board. Future Sight gets a little bit better. Gul'drath Assassin and Old Man of the Sea, not so hot. Unfortunately, we don't have too much to bring in, except maybe this Thirst. And maybe this Grave Robber. It's pretty difficult. I mean, he doesn't have too many creatures, it appears. The Future Sight should be good. And so the weakest creature is probably going to be the Old Man of the Sea. And we've got Gul'drath Assassin sort of clean up. I think that'll end up being fine. Let's see. Other cards that we can take out. Maybe the Fathom Seer is fine. The Short Fang should be fine. It's basically one of the Assassin or the Old Man. I think I would rather have the Assassin, even though the Old Man is better with opposition. So we'll go ahead and do that. It's basically whether or not we want to replace... well, we can also think about Disfigure. And Gul'drath Assassin sort of gets around that a little bit better, just because it can get big, but that's probably not going to be happening too often. I mean, the rest of the black is pretty bad. Alternatively, we can go ahead and bring in Path and Court Hisar, mainly just the Court Hisar. Or we can bring in green, Terrasa and Rude Awakening and Mold Shambler. I actually like that quite a bit. We're taking out Demonic Tutor and we lose Forbidden Alchemy, but we can keep the Underground Sea. So, and Mold Shambler and Rude Awakening and Terrasodon are all pretty reasonable, but I do like the Short Fang and the Nightscape Familiar, and the Demonic Tutor is still fine, so I guess we'll just go like that.